Today I'll be discussing an important and an interesting topic, azoospermia. Definition of male infertility. Infertility is the inability of a sexually active, non-contracepting couple to achieve pregnancy in 1 year. WHO definition. Distribution of infertility. 50% of the cases are females. 30% of the cases are males. 20% of the cases are combined males and females. Definition of azoospermia. It is an absence of sperm cells in semen, zero sperm count, no sperm. Azoospermia is present in 1% of the general male population and in 10 to 15% of infertile men. There are two major etiologic categories of azoospermia: obstructive azoospermia and non-obstructive azoospermia. In obstructive azoospermia, complete spermatogenesis is observed during histological analysis. In non-obstructive azoospermia, either germ cell aplasia, a Sertoli cell only pattern, maturation arrest, or tubular sclerosis and atrophy is revealed by histological analysis. In obstructive azoospermia, spermatozoa can be found. However, in non-obstructive azoospermia, no sperms can be found in the histological analysis. Causes of azoospermia. Pretesticular azoospermia. 2% of men with azoospermia due to a hypothalamic or pituitary abnormality diagnosed with hypogonadotropic hypogonadism. Primary testicular failure, non-obstructive azoospermia, 49% to 93%. It includes reduced spermatogenesis, hypospermatogenesis, maturation arrest, complete failure of spermatogenesis noted with Sertoli cell only syndrome and tubular sclerosis. Post testicular azoospermia, 7% to 51%. It includes normal spermatogenesis, but obstructive azoospermia or retrograde ejaculation. What are the causes of primary testicular failure? They include congenital factors, anorchia, it means no testes, testicular dysgenesis, cryptorchidism, genetic abnormalities such as Klinefelter's syndrome. Acquired factors including trauma, testicular torsion, post-inflammatory orchitis forms, exogenous factors such as cytogenetic drugs, irradiation, heat, systemic diseases such as liver cirrhosis, renal failure, varicocele, surgeries that can damage vascularization of the testes, idiopathic forms, and non-etiology. Genetic analysis of men with azoospermia. Obstructive azoospermia. Cystic fibrosis gene mutation analysis, CFTR gene for the husband and wife. Congenital bilateral absence of the vas deferens in males can occur alone or as a sign of cystic fibrosis, which is inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern. Non-obstructive azoospermia. Karyotype analysis, Y chromosome microdeletion analysis, other gene deletion mutations. Male reproductive system. Male reproductive system consists of testes, duct system, accessory glands, and penis. The testes have two functions: production of male gametes and synthesis and secretion of secretion of testosterone. Spermatozoa are produced in the testes and are carried by the duct system to the exterior. The duct system includes epididymis, vas deferens, ejaculatory duct, and part of the urethra. Accessory glands are seminal vesicles, prostate, and bulbourethral glands. This is the testis inside the scrotum. The conduct system includes epididymis, vas deferens, ejaculatory ducts, and part of urethra. The accessory glands includes seminal vesicles, bulbourethral gland, prostate. The testis is composed of testicular lobule. Testicular lobules, which are separated by septa. The testicular lobule is composed of seminiferous tubules. These are seminiferous tubules in the cross section. In between the seminiferous tubules, there are interstitial cells of Leydig are responsible for testosterone secretion. Seminiferous tubule. In the seminiferous tubules, there are two different types of cells, including Sertoli cells, the spermatogenic cells in varying stages of differentiation. This is the Sertoli cell, which have pyramidal cells, which have prominent nucleoli. They are supportive. Spermatogenic cells include spermatogonia, which are in direct contact with the basement membrane, the primary spermatocytes, which have thin threads of chromatin. They are the largest cells, spermatid, then spermatozoa. Here we can see in H and E staining, this is the Sertoli cells, which are pyramidal in shape. They have prominent nucleoli. They are supportive. The spermatogenic cells include spermatogonia, which are always in direct contact with the basement membrane. Here we can find round spermatid, spermatozoa with tails, elongated head and tails. This high power, we can see spermatogonia, which are in direct contact with the basement membrane. Primary spermatocytes, which have thin threads of chromatin. These are Sertoli cells with prominent nucleoli. They are supportive cells. Spermatozoa, the sperms, they are near to the lumen. After spermation, they will be inside the lumen. When should the exospermic man have a testis biopsy? The biopsy is the initial part of the larger fertility treatment. Close to 60% of the men would need a testicular biopsy to document whether the exospermia is post-testicular normal spermatogenesis or testicular failure with either Sertoli cell only syndrome, maturation arrest pattern, or hypospermatogenesis. Once the biopsy results are available as a quick section, the surgery would then proceed with a reconstruction and or sperm retrieval if active spermatogenesis is detected, or a testicular sperm extraction if a pattern of testicular failure is detected. What is the testicular interpretation of primary testicular failure? First of all, what is called anorchia, regressive testicular syndrome. In this photo, we see spermatic cord and we cannot see testicular tissue. The testicular tissue is replaced by fibrosis, dystrophic calcification with deposition of hemosiderin. You can see here a ghost of seminiferous tubule, a ghost of fibrosis representing seminiferous tubule. This is called anorchia, regressive testicular syndrome, or vanishing testis. Vanishing testis. Tubular sclerosis. What is the tubular sclerosis? Tubular sclerosis means the seminiferous tubules are narrow, sclerosed, fibrosed, without germ cells or Sertoli cells. Sertoli cell only pattern or Sertoli cell only syndrome. We find in the seminiferous tubules Sertoli cells only. The Sertoli cells are pyramidal with prominent nucleoli. They are the only cells that have prominent nucleoli inside the seminiferous tubules. Early maturation arrest, what is called premeiotic or complete maturation arrest. It includes spermatogonial arrest. You can find only spermatogonial cells, the spermatogonia, which are always in direct contact with basement membrane. In this also we can see Sertoli cells. The only spermatogenic cells we can see are spermatogonia, so it is called spermatogonial arrest. Spermatocytic arrest. We can find here spermatogonia and primary spermatocytes. No spermatid, no sperms. It is called early maturation arrest or premeiotic arrest because the spermatogonia and primary spermatocytes are diploid, containing 46 chromosomes. It is the most common cause of testicular infertility. late maturation arrest, what is called post-meiotic or incomplete maturation arrest. It is spermatid arrest. We find spermatogonia, primary spermatocytes, and spermatid, round spermatid, some elongated spermatid. There is total absence of sperms, or there is markedly diminution of the sperms. In this condition, in the condition of spermatid arrest, we can say severe hypospermatogenesis, because when we reach to the level of spermatid, we can find sperms in other seminiferous tubules in the same testis. So it is called severe hypospermatogenesis, or late maturation arrest, or post-meiotic, or incomplete maturation arrest. It has many names. We say post-meiotic because the spermatids have haploid chromosomes. It means 23 chromosomes. The hypospermatogenesis. There are proportional hypoplasia of germ cells. There is. We can see spermatogonia, primary spermatocytes, spermatid, and occasional spermatozoa. We can find spermatozoa. We say hypospermatogenesis. This is the second most common cause of testicular infertility. Normal spermatogenesis. When we see normal spermatogenesis in a testicular biopsy, it means obstructive azoospermia. We see spermatogonia, primary spermatocytes, spermatid, and spermatozoa. I repeat again, when you see normal spermatogenesis in a testicular biopsy, it means obstructive azoospermia. Others, we can see in the testicular biopsy tuberculosis, this is caseating granuloma, idiopathic granulomatous orchitis, torsions, this is torsions, hemorrhagic infarctions here, testicular torsions. Primary testicular failure. There is a famous syndrome called Klinefelter syndrome. It accounts for 10% to 20% of males attending infertility clinics. It is characterized by lack of beard and body hair, long arms, long legs, gynecomastia, hip female-like, lack of pubic hair, testicular atrophy, and infertility. Here we can see the female distribution of pubic hair. In the karyotype, there is an extra X chromosome. So it is 47XXY. Under the microscope, we see what is called Klinefelter pattern. What is Klinefelter pattern? It is tubular sclerosis. Tubular sclerosis means the seminiferous tubules are narrow, sclerosed, fibrosed, without Sertoli cells or spermatogenic cells, no germ cells, and hyperplasia of interstitial cells of Leydig. This is interstitial cells of Leydig, hyperplasia. The cells are located in between the cerebellar tubule. There is no treatment for the sterility caused by Klinefelter syndrome. The second famous cause of testicular failure, primary testicular failure, what is called Y chromosome microdeletion. It is a family of genetic disorders caused by a specific partial deletion of AZFC, azoospermia factor locus called GR deletion at YQ11. There are three regions of the Y chromosome, AZFA, AZFB, and AZFC, with deletions affecting any single or combination of regions, most studies concentrating on AZFC. It is significantly associated with male infertility, about 15%, due to oligospermia or azoospermia among Caucasians in Europe and the Western Pacific region. Many men with Y chromosome microdeletion exhibit no symptoms and lead to normal lives. Complete DNA sequencing of a patient's Y chromosome is the gold standard test. Androgen insensitivity syndrome, or cause testicular feminization. It is a phenotypic female but genetic male with normal or elevated testosterone levels. It is due to unresponsiveness of the cells to the androgen. Most cases of androgen insensitivity syndrome are identified in the newborn period by the presence of inguinal masses, which later are identified as testes during surgery. Some patients are first seen in the teenage years for evaluation of primary amenorrhea and primary infertility. Testes are present in the abdomen, inguinal canal, or labia majora, and are removed after surgery to prevent tumors. The size of the testes varies, and in most cases, tubules have Sertoli cells only. Primary testicular failure. This is a case of true hermaphroditism, which is more common in South Africa than anywhere else in the world. South African gold medalist Semenya, 18 years old, who won a gold medal in the 800-meter run at the World Athletics Championships, is a hermaphrodite. In the hermaphrodite, we can see what is called ovotestis. It means we find seminiferous tubules and follicles, Gravian follicles, in the same gonad. So it is called ovotestis. In primary testicular failure, it is essential to look for what is called intratesticular germ cell neoplasia, because there is an increased risk of malignant development, in particular seminoma. We use what is called PLAP, placental alkaline phosphatase, or CD117, or it is called also CKIT. In this case, it is positive, showing cytoplasmic and membranous positivity. Management of azoospermia. To understand the management of azoospermia, it is important also to understand the assisted reproductive technologies, in vitro fertilization. Assisted reproductive technologies, ARTS. Sperm retrieval from men with non-obstructive and obstructive azoospermia is now possible with excellent pregnancy rates when ECSI is applied. The ability to use cryopreserved, epididymal, and often testicular spermatozoa will continue to limit the number of sperm retrieval procedures necessary to achieve fertility for a couple. Our task for an azoospermic patient is to retrieve and collect sperms using different techniques. Surgical sperm retrieval for obstructive azoospermia, testicular fine needle aspiration, percutaneous epididymal sperm aspiration, microsurgical epididymal sperm aspiration, percutaneous biopsy of the testis, surgical sperm retriever for non-obstructive azoospermia, multiple standard testicular biopsy and percutaneous biopsy, microdissection, testicular sperm extraction. We will discuss one by one. Testicular fine needle aspiration, TFNA, percutaneous puncture and aspiration of the testis can be performed using a 21 to 23 gauge needle connected to 20cc syringe in a syringe holder. Percutaneous epididymal sperm aspiration, what is called PISA. PISA has been advocated because it can be performed without surgical scrotal exploration. It is repeated easily at low cost. A 21 gauge butterfly needle attached to a 20 milliliter syringe is inserted into the caput epididymis and withdrawn gently until fluid can be seen entering the butterfly needle tubing. Percutaneous biopsy of the testis, PERC biopsy. Percutaneous biopsy retrieval is an effective technique that provides the higher yield of spermatozoa for sperm retrieval in obstructive azoospermia. A 14-gauge automatic biopsy gun with a 1 cm excursion is used under local anesthesia to remove a small segment of testicular parenchyma. Microsurgical epididymal sperm aspiration, what is called MISA. It is performed as open operation under the operating microscope. Individual tubules of the epididymis are isolated and micropuncture aspiration is taken. Microdissection testicular sperm extraction. Using a microdissection TESI technique for men with non-obstructive azoospermia, a minimum amount of testicular tissue is excised and a sufficient number of spermatozoa can still be retrieved. Multiple TESI procedures may cause both transient and occasional permanent alterations in testicular function, including testicular atrophy and decrease in testosterone levels. One study showing biopsy pattern and sperm retrieved in cases of Sertoli cell only syndrome the sperm is retrieved in 24% of the cases, in maturation arrest 42%, in hypospermatogenesis 81%, in hypospermatogenesis 81%, in obstructive azoospermia, sperm retrieval is 100%. After the sperm retrieval, there is oocyte retrieval. The egg retrieval process includes 2 to 4 weeks of hormone injections to stimulate ovaries and ripen multiple eggs. When the eggs have matured, the eggs are removed with an ultrasound-guided needle through the vagina. The procedure is conducted under sedation. The eggs are immediately frozen. Cryopreservation. Semen cryopreservation. It is a procedure to preserve sperm cells using glycerol with saccharose as cryoprotectant. The ultra cold of liquid nitrogen at -196°C is required for successful preservation of the more complex biological structures to virtually stop all biological activity. For human sperm, the longest reported successful storage is 22 years. Oocyte cryopreservation. It is aimed at particular groups of women, cancer, chemotherapy, family history of early menopause. Embryo cryopreservation. This includes situation where there is a risk of a woman having severe ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. In vitro fertilization. Oocytes are retrieved from the ovaries, then are either incubated with the sperm in a dish or intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Light microscopy image showing a sperm and egg at the moment of conception during in vitro fertilization. The sperm needed to penetrate these cells and the membrane surrounding the egg, called the zona pellucida, if successful fertilization is to occur. This is in the dish, this is the ovum, this is the sperm trying to penetrate the zona pellucida surrounding the ovum. Intracytoplasmic sperm injection, ICSI. It is injecting the sperm directly into the cytoplasm of the oocyte, which is retrieved from the ovaries. ICSI technique was developed and perfected by the Brussels University and institution of St. Louis. Testicular sperm retrieval is successful in virtually 100% of patients with obstructive azoospermia, and sufficient numbers of spermatozoa can be obtained for ICSI and or cryopreservation. Testicular sperm retrieval is about 60% of patients with non-obstructive azoospermia. It should be a home message. Testicular sperm retrieval is about 60% of patients with non-obstructive azoospermia. The only hope for non-obstructive azoospermic patients with failed spermatozoa retrieval to father their own genetic children is the use of more immature germ cells for ICSI, that is, spermatids and secondary spermatocytes. We repeat again, the only hope for non obstructive endospermic patients with failed spermatozoa retriever to father their own genetic children is the use of more immature germ cells for eggs, spermatids, and secondary spermatocytes. We use spermatids and secondary spermatocytes because they are haploid. They contain only 23 chromosomes. However, we do not use spermatogonia or primary spermatocytes because they are diploid. They contain 46 chromosomes. Indications for ICSI: where a previous IV cycle has resulted in failed fertilization. If the number of sperm in the ejaculate is very low, oligospermia. If the motility of the sperm is poor, asthenospermia. If the morphology shape of the sperm is poor, teratospermia. If there are no sperm in the ejaculate, exospermia. If there are anti-sperm antibodies. If there are frozen sperm only available with limited counts and motility. Using ICSI, it is now possible to produce a pregnancy with any live sperm, moving or not, from either the semen or any site within the male reproductive tract. Sperm could be retrieved from any site in the reproductive tract and used for ICSI. Pregnancy rates close to 50 to 80% per cycle of ICSI. Women under 35 years old are expected, with the pregnancy rates independent of the site of the origin of the sperm. This is a micro manipulation showing ICSI. This is a holder, this is the ovum, this is micropipette injector containing the sperm. It is being injected directly into the cytoplasm of the ovum. This micro manipulation is successful. Embryo transfer procedure for in vitro fertilization. Embryo transfer usually occurs on the third day following egg retrieval. Some couples may benefit from a day 5 blastocyst transfer. Blastocyst transfer involves growing embryos to the blastocyst stage, usually day 5, which allows more accurate assessment of the embryo's implantation potential. Pre-implantation genetic diagnosis is indicated because of the danger of transferring genetic problems to the next generation. Take your baby. In the infertility center of St. Louis, over 10,000 babies have been born with this new technique from men who were otherwise considered hopelessly sterile. The babies are physically, mentally, and genetically completely normal, no matter how poor or miserable the sperm of the father. Conclusions: testicular biopsy is the best procedure to define the histological diagnosis and the possibility of finding sperm. Spermatozoa are found in about 60% of patients with non-obstructive endospermia. Spermatozoa should be cryopreserved for use in ICSI. Men who are candidates for sperm retrieval must receive appropriate genetic advice. For patients with non-obstructive endospermia who have spermatozoa in their testicular biopsy, ICSI with fresh or cryopreserved spermatozoa is the only therapeutic option. Pregnancies and live birth are achieved in 30 to 50% of couples with non-obstructive endospermia when spermatozoa are found in the testicular biopsy. to increase the chances of positive sperm retrievals in men with non-obstructive azoospermia, testicular sperm extraction, single, multiple, or microsurgical should be used rather than testicular fine needle extraction. When no testicular spermatozoa could be retrieved from men with non-obstructive azoospermia, intracytoplasmic injection with spermatids, rosy round spermatid injection, or LC elongated spermatid injection can be used. Thank you.